Yes, FoodTube, how are you? Food Busker in the house at Camden Lock, locking it down in a culinary rude boy styly. Now, this week, I'm gonna do a po' boy, but I'm gonna make an oyster po' boy. I'm gonna shuck some oysters, I'm gonna pan them, deep fry them, it's gonna be crunchy oyster loveliness. Then I'm gonna do a sriracha mayo, I'm gonna wrap it all up in a beautiful brioche bun. Let's get the slaw ready. Red cabbage. I'm gonna take out the core and thinly slice. The reason you want it thin is this is a delicate sandwich. You don't want big chunks of cabbage in there, it would ruin it. So nice and thin. If you can't slice it, then grate it. Next, white cabbage. Core out, thinly slice. Okay, carrot. So I'm just scraping off the skin. It's a really quick way to peel it. And then I'm gonna slice it into thin strips. Half a red onion. Okay, now let's get this little lot into here. Mix all those together and then grab your pomegranate, cut it in half, and then just pick through the pomegranate that you've knocked through to make sure that you've got no pith in there. I'm gonna zest half a lemon in there, and then squeeze half the lemon in. Squeeze it into your hand so you catch any pips. Okay, now a good pinch of sea salt in there. Make sure you use the good stuff. Now let's set that aside and make the mayo. Sriracha mayo, couldn't be simpler. Mayo, sriracha, hence the name. Okay, now you make it to the consistency and the hotness that you like. I put about a tablespoon in to 100 grams of mayo, but you do what suits you. Okay, now I'm gonna show you how to shuck an oyster. This is an essential tool to shuck oysters safely. An oyster knife. Now, come and have a sniff. What we're doing is the knife needs to go into the hinge there. It needs to go in and twist and pop the shell open. Get your cloth. This is really important that you do this right because you can hurt yourself. Put your hand in and put the cloth over. Then take your knife and put it into the hinge. Now push in and twist. And then you take the knife and you cut across the top. And that way you release the oyster from the muscle bit that attaches it to the shell. And here, it's attached. So you take your knife, put it under and just cut through and release it from the attachment there. And that's your oyster shucked. I'm gonna rattle on with the others. My six oysters are shucked. Now let's pané them. Roughly about a teaspoon of smoked paprika into 200 grams of plain flour. I'm going to put the oysters into the flour. It helps for the batter, but the second thing it does is it adds a smoky hot flavor. Delicious. Egg wash. It's important to drain off the excess egg. Breadcrumbs. And when all the others are done, they'll go into the deep fat fryer. Okay, they're all breadcrumbed. Now, let's set the burgers up because the only way to eat these bad boys is fresh, crispy, and hot straight out the fryer. Now, I've toasted some brioche buns. Now, the classic way to do this is with a Portuguese sub roll, but I love these because they hold together well and they'll work really well with the sriracha mayo. Next, I've got some iceberg that I've shredded. Put your iceberg on and get a handful of your slaw and drop that on. Now, just look at all the gorgeous colours in there. It's going to add so much crunch and flavour. Let's get the oysters into the fryer. Oysters in. Now, for each bun, I'm using two oysters. I'm frying them at 180 degrees. They should take about a minute and a half. Out onto greaseproof paper, lightly seasoned, then onto the bun. I can't contain my excitement. This is gonna be delicious, I hope. Oh, that is great. Oh, that is so good. It's crunchy, a bit of sponge, slightly sweet. And then that slaw really gives relief, but the sriracha mayo's coming through on the end. That, on its own, without fries, I reckon. Okay, I'm gonna say £6. I'm gonna say it, okay? And let's take two more, take it to the street, and see what the people at Camden will pay for it. Right, lads?
Oh, hi.
You ready? You ready?
Yeah.
You're a big one, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
Oyster po' boy. Come on, grab one each.
This one.
Can't afford to get in an argument with these ones. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Really? For a whole one of those, what would you pay?
£10.
£10? Oh!
10, 12 pounds.
It's awesome. Yeah.
2-0, 2-0, 2-0. Come on, oyster po' boy smashed it out of the park. Those lads were loving it. Now, if you want to see more street food, but this time paired with beer, then zip over to Drinks Tube and check out my mate, Tim Anderson. He's got a brilliant video on getting the two together. Now, what would you have paid for this dish? Let me know in the comments box below. And people, subscribe, brothers and sisters, to FoodTube.